Hi, my name is Dr. Nicola Maher. I'm one of the consultant obstetricians and gynaecologists here at the Rotunda, and I have a special interest in maternal medical conditions and medicine use in pregnancy. Pregnant women are at no more risk of contracting COVID than women who are not pregnant. However, particularly in the third trimester of pregnancy, pregnant women are more at risk of moderate to severe disease. This means they're more at risk of hospitalisation and significantly more at risk of requiring intensive care. There is no need to stop breastfeeding if you are COVID positive. You should continue to breastfeed, but pay particular attention to hand hygiene at the time. COVID vaccine has been proven to reduce moderate to severe disease and death from COVID. This is particularly important from pregnant women who are more at risk of moderate to severe disease. In Ireland, to date, none of the women who we have seen who've been hospitalised in ICU with COVID have been vaccinated. You can get the COVID vaccine at any stage in pregnancy. You may choose to get it at a walk-in vaccination centre, or you may register online with the HSE website. In addition, keep an eye on your maternity hospital's website in case they are offering vaccination clinics. In pregnancy, the recommended vaccine is an mRNA vaccine. This will be given at either 3 or 4 weekly intervals, and your vaccine centre or where you receive the vaccine will advise you when to next attend. There is no evidence of the vaccine causing harm to babies. The vaccine itself does not cross the placenta where baby is. What crosses the placenta is the antibody that your body produces after receiving a vaccine. This antibody has been found in newborn infants' mum, a blood of mums that have been vaccinated. This means potentially that these babies are also protected from COVID-19. You may be concerned about the risk of blood clots in pregnancy. The mRNA vaccines have no associated increased risk of blood clots, and indeed an AstraZeneca vaccine does not have an increased risk of the types of blood clots that we are concerned about in pregnancy. Being pregnant does not increase your risk of blood clots after a vaccine. There have been many concerning reports about vaccine affecting fertility. However, when we look at the evidence around vaccines and fertility, there is no evidence that vaccines affect either male or female fertility. There are now numerous pregnancies accounted for in the literature which have happened after people have received the vaccine. Both COVID-19 as a disease and the COVID vaccines are new. However, we now have data on hundreds of thousands of women who have received this vaccine across the world. There are now numerous scientific studies showing how safe the vaccine is. These studies show there is no increase in miscarriage rates, no increase in congenital abnormalities or babies born with small abnormalities. There is no increased risk in growth problems. There is no increased risk in stillbirth, and there is no increased risk in preterm labor. In comparison, COVID-19 in pregnancy carries significant risk for your baby, including a doubling of the risk of stillbirth and a doubling of the risk of preterm birth. Some people have expressed concerns about why we don't have more long-term data on the use of these vaccines. These are new vaccines, but the vaccines themselves do not cross the placenta. Only the antibody formed in your body to protect you and your baby crosses the placenta, and there is no scientific plausible reason why this would cause any harm for your infant. Initially, in January, when the vaccines were introduced, many women chose to wait until after their baby was born to get the vaccine. Now we have much more information supporting the safety of these vaccines than we did in January. But more concerning, we are also seeing a change in the pattern of how COVID is behaving in pregnancy. and we are seeing a particularly high incidence of severe disease in the third trimester. Therefore, the best way to protect you and your baby is to get the vaccine as soon as possible in pregnancy. The vaccine is very safe to receive when breastfeeding your baby. There are also studies now which show that the antibodies produced by your body cross into breast milk and that your baby will also benefit from these antibodies during breastfeeding. You may experience some side effects from your vaccine. This is true of all vaccines. You may have a sore arm, or in some cases, you may have a fever, which usually is short-lived and resolves within 24 hours. It is fine to take paracetamol if you have a fever. If you received a first dose of AstraZeneca prior to becoming pregnant, it is now recommended that you receive a second dose of Pfizer or Moderna as soon as possible. This is not because there is concerns about the use of AstraZeneca in pregnancy, but there are more readily supplies available of Pfizer or Moderna in Ireland, and it will be easier for you to receive a vaccine at short notice. It is also recommended to receive two other vaccines in pregnancy. These would be the flu vaccine and the pertussis or whooping cough vaccine. There is no need to wait any interval after taking either of these vaccines or receiving either of these vaccines before receiving your COVID vaccine. In addition, if you are scheduled to receive anti-D in pregnancy, there is no need to wait after receiving that before receiving your mRNA vaccine. There is no need to wait any time after having your baby to receive a COVID vaccine. You can receive this as soon as you feel well enough, and it would be recommended to do so. If you are currently trying to conceive, it is recommended you go ahead and get your COVID vaccine. You do not need to wait any interval after having a COVID vaccine to try and conceive, or indeed to embark on any fertility treatment. If you have had COVID in the last 6 months, you would still be recommended to receive a COVID vaccine. However, you do need to allow 4 weeks after all symptoms have resolved from your COVID infection prior to doing this.